But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such things there is no law. The first fruit of the Spirit is love. The Greek word for this is different from the words for romantic love or brotherly love. This word signifies goodwill or benevolence. It's about putting others ahead of ourselves. It's more than just a mere emotion. It necessarily involves actions. So this love is produced by following the Spirit, walking by the Spirit, being led by the Spirit, and it will be produced as we follow the word that the Spirit revealed to us. So love is going to be demonstrated in our conduct in a couple of ways. First, our love for God is going to be shown through our obedience to His word. Jesus said, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments," John 14 and verse 15. Second, our love for others will be demonstrated in our actions as we do good and not harm to others. Paul wrote in Romans 13:10 that love does no wrong to a neighbor. Therefore, love is the fulfillment of the law. John also wrote in 1 John 3:16 that we know love by this, that he laid down his life for us, talking about Jesus, he laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for the brethren. For both of these, love for God and love for others, it is not enough simply to claim that we love. John said, 1 John 3:18, "Little children, let us not love with word or with tongue, but in deed and truth." Love needs to be shown in our actions. If we only talk about love and our conduct does not back that up, then our words are hollow. But love will also influence our decisions. Again, love seeks the well-being of others ahead of ourselves. So in making any decision, we must consider how others are going to be affected by it. As Paul told the church in Philippi of the love that they were to have for one another, he said in Philippians 2, 3, and 4, "Do nothing from selfishness or empty conceit, but with humility of mind regard one another as more important than yourselves. Do not merely look out for your own personal interests, but also for the interests of others." So each one of us can ask ourselves the question, is love being produced in my life? If we are following the influence of the Spirit, this will be one of the natural products of that. So if we do not see this in our lives, then we need to go back to the Word of God and be reminded of what our lives are to look like in this regard. And if we do see this in our lives, then we need to continue in that direction. Continue to follow the influence of the Spirit as He has shown us in His Word.